Well, I guess it depends what we mean by smart. And I think that smart has come to be a term that means integrating technology into design. Sometimes it means hiding technology into design. I think for our work as interior architects, it's useful to divide it into, say, active smart and passive smart. Things that are actively smart might be those that hide the technology, and things that are passively smart might be those that embed the smartness into planning, for example.
I think you can make smart design decisions when you're planning a building and or when you're doing an interior design, and it's really important not only to think about smart technical things, but also thinking about smart design and planning decisions. So we create spaces, and the idea of the space is to see the beauty of the space. So you don't want to see air conditioning, you don't want to see light switches, you don't want to see electrical plugs, you don't want to see cables. So the biggest challenge for us is to bring everything together and then find a way of hiding it or to really show it. That's the other way.
People come to us because they want a space that is beautiful, a space that works well, a space that's comfortable, and a space that is desirable. Part of that is the technology that exists within it, certainly plumbing, electricity, heat, electric lights, ease of use, smart technologies are part of that. But to be honest, that's not the primary motivator for us. We want to integrate all of that stuff, but frankly, we don't want to celebrate it, we want to hide it.
That's smart if you don't realize it as a user. So it's not the goal to have the same light level all over the space. Like in the Villa Kellermann, we created together with a light planner different atmospheres. In one room it's darker and the light comes in eye height, and another room the light comes from above and we have different light elements standing at the walls. So it's all about creating atmospheres and also contrasts with light. And the same thing is for air conditioning, you know, you don't want always like the air blowing on you. I think you should be always able to open a window. So you can make something very smart, but the most important thing that it's not smarter than you are, you know?
We want a smart building rather than a stupid building. But what do we mean by smart? Well, in a passive way of being smart, we want to plan things so that they're all in the right place. We want to take advantage of natural light. We want to take advantage of natural flow. We want people to feel comfortable. We want people to be able to use it in a way that is the way it's set up to be used. That's smart. It would be stupid not to do those things. And so it's important to embed smartness in the very planning of what we do. Part of that is technological. Part of it is to create technologies that allow us to control all of the electrical devices that are in our home.
Well, for me, a smart building or a smart interior is something where it focuses on other things, you know, where materials, colors are sustainable and are beautiful, and you don't really see how it works, and that you feel at home immediately while entering it.
Well, I think the best smart building is one where the technology is absolutely invisible and you don't notice it at all, and it's completely intuitive.